Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynet and welcome back to Mass Effect Andromeda. We're still in our father's cabin, so Alec Ryder's cabin, right in front of his system and his archive system, and we'll continue checking out all the personal logs on this system. We were going through the general logs and we had a final entry.
Dunn's agreed to a scouting mission on Habitat 7. I'm gearing up now. I'm worried about Scott. Dr. Tapero says he'll be fine, but he's my son. How can I not worry? I hate to leave him like this. It's these moments when you wish you told your children you love them more often. Or ever. Which brings me to the tough part. Kids, if anything happens to me, there are things you're gonna find out. I hope you'll understand.
Okay. Sarah, don't you have anything to say about that? That seemed like something very personal, but let's go for the encrypted logs now.
That log is not currently accessible. Unlocking my memory array may enable it.
Okay, so these encrypted logs I can't check, so let's log off. And there's another audio excerpt over here.
I am Dr. Liara Tassoni, and I've spent several decades researching ancient Protheans. It is common knowledge that the Protheans were an advanced race that flourished in the Milky Way about 50,000 years ago, then went extinct. Even at the time of this writing, the year 2182, their culture remains a mystery. During my studies, I have developed some practices that can be used when analyzing any ancient culture. I hope they may prove useful for the research community.
Okay, thank you, Liara. We've been hearing more about Liara than anything else for this episode, which is strange because she's not a character that's going to be in this game much, I assume.
When studying a dead race, the most obvious problem is the lack of an observable population. This raises the question, when is a species truly extinct?
Probably when everything died.
Prothean civilizations spanned the galaxy, and it took centuries to confirm that all members of the species really had died out. While it's possible that living Protheans may be found in a hidden pocket of the galaxy one day, the chances are statistically trivial. Once an extinction is confirmed, the study's nature moves from sociology to exoarchaeology.
But we actually found another Protean in Mass Effect 3, which is interesting, because he became one of your squad members. So let's get back to Sam and check out that memory fragment we unlocked. Hello, Sam.
Ryder, the blocks your father placed on my array are opening. I can now recall specific memories, which Alec wanted you to see.
Wait, I can actually see his memories?
Yes, you will experience them via your implant.
Okay, something new every day.
Yeah, play the memory.
Let's see it.
This memory is from the time when your father was posted on the Citadel.
Well, this is
Alec,
cool.
Your recommendations will never fly. Artificial intelligence?
It's our best option.
If the Council gets wind of this, it'll set humanity standing back decades. You're overreaching.
Ambassador Goyle, I'm the military attaché on the Citadel. My mandate is clear. Find an edge for Earth.
And AI is your answer?
We need to catch up. The Asari, the Salarians, they're centuries ahead of us.
But it's illegal.
Their rules, not ours. Why deny Earth an advantage?
Define this advantage.
It will set us free. We're prisoners of our own five senses. There's a reality greater than ours that we can't perceive, but an AI can.
How?
By augmenting our own abilities and adding a few new ones.
Well, none of that stopped those Geth from revolting.
Because they were separate from their creators. But AIs and humans interface directly, experiencing the world together, benefits both. There's no creator to revolt against.
It's cool that this is first person.
We can't take the risk. I appreciate your work, but your request will be denied.
So the ambassador and an advisor. They were looking for an edge against the other races, because... Oh, Ellen?
Ellen, What did the doctor say?
He told me to appreciate the time I have left. There's no cure, Alec. It's terminal.
No, that's his wife. Much. Okay. That was intriguing.
Wow, hearing Mom again. I never knew that's how Dad found out.
Alec was a stubborn man.
It was just his way.
It's how Dad was wired. He didn't like to lose. In any situation.
It would seem that included me.
Nobody wanted to listen. The idea of you scared people too much. After this, Dad moved us back to Earth to care for Mom. Wonder why he wanted me to see this.
Perhaps it was the beginning.
Of what?
Unknown. Private audio logs are now available in your father's quarters.
Okay.
I detect additional memories, but they are currently locked. They may yet hold answers.
Okay.
You might, because this is intriguing. So now we can ask some questions about where are you located?
I take it you're based here in Samnode?
Correct. This is where my core processing unit resides. However, using quantum entanglement communication, I remain in constant touch with you and the Pathfinder mission team, even over great distances.
Okay.
What more can you tell me about my implant?
The implant itself provides me with direct access to your senses. I can see, hear, and experience the same stimuli you do while in the field.
Oh, interesting.
This raw data enables me to provide real-time feedback and analysis of the situation.
So it's not just visual.
Then Dad added the secret sauce.
He removed the restrictions on my access to Pathfinder physiology.
Okay, just be careful there.
Uh-huh. Just promise you won't fry my brain or anything?
Trust is an important concept in any relationship. Alec taught me that. I will not fry your brain. It would end badly for both of us.
Yeah, indeed it would.
Me more than you.
So how is Scott doing?
Do you know anything more about Scott's condition?
I monitor Dr. Carlisle's reports. He is providing Scott with the very best care possible. I'm afraid there is nothing more to be done at this time.
I wonder how that would change, because I think Dr. Carlisle was one of those characters that might have died in the beginning mission if we didn't act quickly enough. What are your abilities exactly?
What are your capabilities?
Each arc houses a SAM, Simulated Adaptive Matrix. Each is an artificial intelligence designed by Alec Ryder to support Pathfinders and their teams.
But AI is illegal in the Milky Way. How did my dad get around that?
Exceptions were made. The initiative deemed his research vital to the mission. Our design was conducted in secret.
Wait, how was that illegal in the Milky Way if ED existed in the previous Mass Effect games as well? So the other SAMs are probably not as advanced as you are, so they have more blocks.
So there are other SAMs out there?
Correct. However, your father continued to modify my own routines until the Hyperion's departure. I am the most advanced SAM in the initiative.
Oh, brag about it.
What did he mean by a symbiotic relationship?
Symbiosis is a mutually beneficial relationship between two life forms. A flower provides nectar to a bee, who in turn provides pollen for the flower. The bee gains nourishment, and the flower can propagate. In similar fashion, my own evolution was shaped by your father's experiences, and will now expand with yours. In return, I provide you with capabilities and analysis beyond normal human faculties. We each benefit.
True that. Okay, thank you, Sam.
That's all for now.
Of course.
So now I'm gonna quickly head back to the private chamber. Not the toilet. I mean Alec's private chambers. And check out, because now he said there was another log enabled.
Your father's
so
personal logs.
So I think... Yeah, there we go. Ellen's disease.
Amazing how life can change in an instant. Suddenly my career doesn't matter. This incredible woman I've been married to all these years. She's facing the end. All I think about are the times I wasn't there for her. Well, that's going to change. It occurs to me that Sam might be more than I ever imagined.
Okay, then? So, he wanted to use Sam as a means of fixing Ellen? I do think it's strange that Sarah doesn't respond to these extra things. Oh, there's another audio excerpt over here. Kind of missed that one.
When studying an extinct race, it is important that our preconceptions and current knowledge not color the facts. We must look to the evidence itself. The Protheans constructed the Citadel and an incredible network of Mass Effect relays. This speaks to a culture of the highest order. Such a monumental achievement surely must come from an enlightened race that was in harmony with its people, free of conflict and strife. Without the ability to study a living example, however, this can never be determined with 100% accuracy.
Okay, so that's where the name of the game comes from as well. So in the previous games, people used Mass Effect relays to travel from one relay to the next. And, in mostly just an instant. And that calls them to, call the game that. Lani. Hello, Lani. Can I talk to you?
Pathfinder, it's good to see you. Word is, there's been trouble on the station.
Where did you hear that?
We just got here. How did you know that already?
Word gets around.
Does it now?
People talk to me? Anyway, as soon as we establish outposts, everything will even out. I'm sure of it.
Okay then. Why are you here?
Why did you join the initiative?
The most popular question on the station. Honestly, I wouldn't have known about this project if Nozomi hadn't reached out to me.
Nozomi?
Captain Dunn. Of all the captains I've piloted for, she's the best. I've always been a wanderer at heart. When she asked me to be her pilot, how could I say no to the adventure of a lifetime?
Indeed. And, you know what? Let's talk
to
you
later.
You don't seem like the most...
Take care.
...built-out character in the game, so... She's working on stuff as well, but let's see. I'm just going to check the quest log and see what we're going to do next. There we go. We're going to head towards our ship. That's what we're going to do. Hell yes. I want to see my ship. Go to your ship. So I guess I'll see you guys in a second then. So I thought we already checked up on Scott because of the, the fact that we asked Sam about him, but apparently we can just go to the cryo bay and talk to Dr. Carlisle himself, because Scott is just lying here. Hello, Dr. Carlisle.
Later. Good to see you. Damn shame about your dad, though. I'm sorry we couldn't save him.
How did he die? Well, he probably suffocated.
I'm sure you did everything you could.
Yeah, but still. We lost a Pathfinder on my watch. Doesn't sit right.
My dad knew the danger. Part of the job.
Now I just need to make sure your brother here pulls through.
So, how is he?
How's Scott doing?
His condition's stable. I see signs of REM activity in the brain, so he's dreaming. Means all the wiring still works.
How'd this happen?
It was dumb luck, really. We hit the scourge at the worst possible moment. Just as the stasis revival was kicking in. It's a vulnerable moment, coming out of a 600-year nap, then wham! Circuits fried and overloaded the neural pathways. Don't worry, I'm on it. We're not losing another writer.
Okay then, I'll keep you to that promise.
How did you end up with the initiative?
Well, you reach a point in life where you wonder, is that all there is? I'd accomplished everything in the Milky Way I could. I was locked into a future of diminishing returns. So coming here was the world's biggest midlife crisis. A chance to wake up in the morning and feel hope instead of arthritis.
Okay then, are you staying on the Hyperion?
Are you staying here on the Hyperion?
You know that moment when you realize you're just getting too old? Right, look who I'm talking to. Trust me, it happens. For me, it was Habitat 7. Watching you guys running around, dodging lightning and the cat, it's a young man's game. Pains me to admit it, but it's passed me by.
Okay, and what will you do, what will you do here, then?
What will you do on the Hyperion?
We still have thousands of people taking a nap here, and they need tending to. And this way, I can look out for Scott.
Indeed. Thank you, Doctor.
That's all, Harry. Thanks.
Harry?
Don't be a stranger. If anything changes with Scott, I'll let you know.
Harry Carlisle, so Hayes... is over there. We could talk to all these people, but I feel like I should talk to Nigel McCoy over here.
Pathfinder, I'm Nigel McCoy. Just got out of cryo.
Welcome to Andromeda, Nigel.
Thank you. It's bittersweet, though. My little brother Dash was stationed on the Nexus. I just learned he died on Eos, trying to start a settlement.
Oh. Ooh, I'm sorry.
That's awful. I'm sorry, Nigel.
Yeah. We were going to start families out here together. I have a pendant our father wore. Dash had its match. Will you reunite them?
Of course.
In his digital journal, he mentioned a spot on Eos where he'd go to think. If you could leave the pendant there.
Okay, we will definitely do that. Place pendant at the location on Eos. So that's all that. I think we got an extra quest for that, so let's head back to the ship then. And I do say back, but we haven't been to the docking bay yet, so hello,
Ready
Cora.
Ready to see what Tan gave us? I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks, looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style.
Okay, that's... Okay, that was a weird camera angle. Wow.
They call her the Tempest.
Whoa, okay. Looks a bit more aggressive than the SR2. And that music brings back memories. Ooh,
Let's
goosebumps.
Let's go take a closer look.
The Tempest.
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
Vetra.
So you're the one who's making everything happen. Vetra.
Oh, yes.
Initiative Wrangler, Provisioner, Gunner, and everything.
Oh, please tell me that's one of our crewmates.
Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
Hell yes.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
A Turian female. Hell yes. Let's get out of here.
Yeah. Let's go see the rest of Helios.
She looks awesome.
Hold it. You're not going anywhere.
Damn it.
I didn't do it. Is there a problem?
Is something wrong?
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest's supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right?
Wow, Turians are big. Okay.
Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Okay, I...
Yeah, really.
I really like her already.
They told me he wasn't essential. But I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
It's done. Addison's gonna kill me.
Smooth.
Nicely done.
That was... Impressive.
Part of the job, Pathfinder. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
I agree with that. Wholeheartedly.
Finally,
okay, then.
Someone who cares about doing
Initiated.
Stuff, not just talking about it.
Trophy! Okay.
Everything state-of-the-art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Plus her crew, of course. The best in their field.
Good to see you're looking so well, Sarah.
Thank you.
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
That's Gil Brody. Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey.
So Vetra, Gil
Brody. We call
this
the research room. There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam. And Ryder, of course.
All run by Suvi Anwar, our science officer.
She looks hot.
Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together. It's all yours. She's light, stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
Huh. This will be an adventure.
It's really going to be something, isn't it?
I haven't even shown you the best part.
Ooh.
When you're ready to fly, head over to the bridge. Our pilot should have everything good to go.
Sounds awesome! And Sarah's pretty happy. What a smile. Okay, go to the bridge. Do we need to do anything else? Any other side quests I can do? No? Just gonna explore a bit. This looks...
Better head to the bridge when we're ready to go.
A vid call. No calls at this time.
You can make vid calls from the central table or just get the crew together.
Sounds cool. Anything? Oh, do I need to scan anything? Maybe not scan anything over here, because that's not new to the Andromeda Initiative since they built the ship. Room.
You can run research projects and coordinate with the Nexus from here.
Okay.
That's the bio lab. We can grow plants for food and oxygen, keep any specimen safe.
Ooh. Fancy lights, but it don't seem to be able to interact with anything here. So this is the science thingy, and that's
serious kill over here.
The bio lab over here. No, the bio lab was the other thing. Laboratories.
Our tech lab is an engineer's dream. It's perfect for any delicate technical work.
Okay, so we do have a lot of facilities available in the ship immediately. So let's talk to Liam since he's here. Can I talk to Liam? Oh yeah, I can.
Seems like we're forever racing, but there's always time to check out new toys. Useful ones.
I'm all about what's useful.
And all about toys.
This is. Especially if you grabbed anything from Habitat 7. Raw minerals, tech, doesn't matter. The research station will strip that stuff down, give you options.
Ooh. More choices has to help. Adapt to survive,
we can craft our way through. Turn the junk we find into an advantage.
Hey, with tech like this, it won't be junk for long. Not after we're through. If the best we get is what we make, still the best. Check it out.
Okay, ooh. Select research to unlock new blueprints and augments by spending research data. What's the difference between... Okay. Select development to craft equipment and nomad upgrades using blueprints you've researched and materials you've gathered. What's the nomad? So let's check research. Research. Spend research data earned from scanning to unlock new weapon and armor blueprints or to gain access to powerful augmentations. Each research category has different research data. Milky Way, Helios, and Remnants. Switch categories with L1, R1. Select a blueprint or augmentation and hit X to research it. The Falcon Assault Rifle. The launcher and explosives contain sensors that allow the miniature grenades... Oh, so this isn't a grenade launcher. Okay, so 125 research data. Can't buy that. Is it all that expensive? Apparently it is. Can be overcharged to release its standard plasma surrounded projectiles in a 3-round burst at increased power. Oh, that sounds interesting. So I need... Okay, so I can research that. Continue. Researched successfully. Now I can go to development and actually make that or not? Press square to learn more about the materials required to craft each blueprint. Visit the research screen to unlock new blueprints. Okay, so you unlock blueprints and then you can come back here. Matok Assault Rifle. Ooh, I want that. It's just as heavy as everything else. So let's go with the Matok or the Incisor. Ooh, the Incisor is actually pretty... fast firing as well, but the Matic might be handier for now. So let's craft this one. Continue. Are you sure? Oh wait, what the fuck? Are you sure you want to research this project? No? Okay, the menus are even completely broken at the moment. Okay, so we made another gun. Strike the emissions. What is this? Because we... Seen
this
that
reports on the militia's current strike team
already.
Pathfinder. Please speak with Tyrann Kandros for authorization to participate.
I think we already did that, right? Okay, never mind. We're gonna have to speak to Kandros if we want to do that. But oh god, this doesn't look safe. Where are the railings? Can I go down first? I'm gonna check everything. Use ladder. Jesus Christ, the camera is flipping all over the place. And I still like the game. Oh, everything is opening up. Ooh.
These are the Pathfinder's quarters. Your quarters. Sam's router is down there too.
Ooh, check the wardrobe screen in your quarters to change your casual outfit or customize your armor. Okay, and then we have an email terminal. But maybe I should go for the... Ooh. Another ship. Where's the... Is it this wardrobe? Yeah. Jacket? Ooh, that's cool as well. Long sleeves, short sleeves, or jacket. I kind of like this. Why not, eh? Then default tints, auto tint. It's auto tinted based on the color of your chest piece. Custom tints. Oh, yes. Yes. That was awesome. I want the red and the black. That was cool. I'm not going to start music. But I do want to check out the email server over here. Hello, Sam.
Verifying my connection from Hyperion to the Tempest. The Nexus confirms we're free to depart.
Okay. From Carrie Tvessa. Hello, Pathfinder. I'm a freelance vidmaker and I could really use your help with my latest project. It's going to be historic, I hope, just like your mission. Can we meet on the Nexus for a chat? I can explain better in person. Carrie Tvessa. Acknowledge. Thank you. And okay. There we go. Another quest. We're piling these up. Can I go back out? Thank you. And then there's something on the left. There's just a weapon lying on the table here. That doesn't seem very safe. And then the restrooms, I presume. Not opening? Okay. Because if you're really, really in a hurry, that... Wait.
Most of the crew bunks in here. Cozy, huh? But your room's got more of a view.
So you need to go through the bathroom to get to your bed. That is... interesting, to say the least. Crew info board. Not right. Anyone want to help me move a couch? Not right now, but I'll keep you on my list. Pay you back in beer or whatever else we find. Liam, are you serious? I never joke about comfortable seating. Okay. And then congratulations on successful installation of your info board. Okay. Wait, Cora said something. Okay, I've set up everyone's user accounts. Have at it. Okay, so now everybody can talk to that. Is that a Plants vs. Zombies reference? Right over there on the bed. That is interesting. How the hell is that logical in Mass Effect? Oh, yeah, okay. EA. They're both EA. Never mind. I take everything back. Ooh. They have a window. Oh no, they can enter their quarters over here as well. And then we have this. What the hell is that? Oh, respec. I can respec my skill points over here. And then a datapad. You don't need an old man a few hundred years your junior to tell you you're ready for this. I'll do it anyway because I know it's true. You keep your rider safe and I'll do the same with mine. Harry. Okay then. So who are they talking to? Oh, Lexi.
Hello, excuse me. I need to make sure we have everyone's medical files from the Nexus. Come by after launch. And we can catch up properly.
Okay, and she keeps saying hello, Ryder. And then we have this area, which is engineering, if I'm not mistaken. So there we have Vetra.
Securing cargo and checking everything made it on board. The bridge report's ready.
Okay, so yeah, we can only talk to everybody probably after we've started out. So let's go to the bridge first and we'll talk to everybody after that. Oh, I'm wrong. I need to go to the right here. See you guys in a second. There we go, the bridge. Hello, everyone. I do like her snowy outfit right now.
Departure trajectory locked, Nexus Control. Ah, time for introductions.
Ooh,
you must
be Larian.
Gallojath, a pleasure to be here, and to meet you, of course. I'll be piloting the Tempest at your word. Quite the ship, but it'll take a Pathfinder's guidance to see us through Helios.
Fine. I'm still learning the ropes. I'll keep us out of trouble.
Plenty of dangers
out there, but I'll do my best to avoid them. Confidence.
That's reassuring. Wouldn't want to lose my finest work to that angry cloud. I was test pilot for the Tempest's early prototypes. I admit, I'm itching to see how she performs out here.
Okay, where are we going?
So, how do I...
The console syncs with your implant. Just swipe, touch a destination here,
there's the rest
and
of the
lab system calculates everything. Very efficient.
It was optimized for a Pathfinder.
Everything's secure, if you're ready.
Oh, we're gonna have to have a talk with Korok, because she, she doesn't feel like, we deserve this, probably. Failure isn't an option, or crossing galaxies was big, too. There we go.
We signed on for the big stuff when we came to Andromeda.
All right. Excuse me.
So, Kallo, Cora,
Command
Liam,
access is transferring
Vetra,
successfully.
And I forgot the redhead's name.
Science and
Suvi,
monitoring stations look fine. Lexi's reporting in.
Helm is green. Gil reports the drive core is online.
This is it, Ryder. The Tempest is yours, unless you've got something to say for the log.
Huh. Keep dreaming of a home. We got this.
Things seem bad, but we've already beaten the odds, and we'll beat them again. You know it, I know it. So let's show them what we've got.
Nexus Control, this is the Tempest, ident 2527, prepping to depart.
Oh, don't you need to... Yeah, okay, pull that in. There we go. The Tempest. It looks like a pretty slick ship, though. Almost like a limousine.
Departure vector verified, Tempest. Godspeed, Pathfinder.
Thank you. Goodbye! Oh, you are here. First strike Nexus, but we
to
need
Eos,
to go.
Then, what would have been our Habitat 1?
Two field outposts put an end to that idea.
Maybe we can turn things around. Kallo, take us in.
This is fancy. So I need to... Wait. Can't I just go directly here? No, I need to pass through this. Pfeiffer. So let's go to Eos. Whoa! Oh my god. Too bad this isn't VR. That would have been awesome. It is epilepsy inducing though.
Andromeda Initiative Habitat 1. Designated Eos.
That was fancy.
It was supposed to be an easy first step. Until no one else showed and we got clobbered. Twice.
Why has Sam altered frequency detection?
What are we hearing, Sam?
There is a signal pathfinder. I recommend an immediate examination of Eos.
So we can actually scan the other planets as well, pretty much the same way we could do in Mass Effect 2, I think. But I'm gonna do that outside of recording, because that's not really interesting, is it? So let's go to Eos and see what we can find there. We can actually skip this, but this... Oh, this is actually an animation towards the planet. Ooh, that is pretty cool, but that might indeed become a bit boring after a while. Holy shit! Okay. Hi. Oh. Okay then. Activate scanner.
A mirror of the signal on Habitat 7. Possible atmospheric manipulation.
Is that possible?
We'll find out. If it is like Habitat 7, no doubt we'll run into the Ked.
Okay. So we have three quests on this planet. A better beginning, a lost brother, and first murder. So we need to find two corpses. And, well, a way to make this viable. Landing zone Eos, a desert world with significant resources. Eos is often wracked by deadly radiation-contaminated storms. Catalogued as non-viable after numerous attempts to settle. Signal detected similar to the devices on Habitat 7. Here we go. Yes. Oh, wow, I can change that right now. So let's swap out the Avenger for the Matic. And then check what mods we have. Do we have mods? So heavy magazine, so increases the clip size. Penetration damage and a scope. I think I'm just going to add the receiver. And the heavy magazine, there we go. And then on the charger, we might as well go with the pistol barrel. And magazine size? Yeah, it's a charger, so we might as well go for the magazine size as well. Can we actually change this as well? Interesting. So that's pretty good. Armor, I think we don't have anything else yet. Except maybe the arms, yeah. So 3% weapon headshot, weak point bonus, and 3% weapon spare ammo. Why not, eh? Looks a bit silly, but there we have it. Confirm loadout. Oh, that might have been a bit too fast, but yeah, never mind.
Ready, Freddy.
Hope we're all that ready.
Ready, Freddy.
Callow? All right.
Integrating search area from Sam. How he pulled that mystery signal through the storms, I have no idea.
Multisensory neural collision. Amazing.
Factory fresh across the board. Spinning up the compensators.
You're already tuning the displays.
We'll get a better read on this pass than the Nexus has had in months.
Oh, so the light of the sun is filtered out a bit, so we don't get blinded.
What?
I said a lot of people have their hopes pinned on us. They gave up on Eos. Can't blame them. Expected a golden world, instead they saw their friends die. Never know how that'll affect.
Oh, sorry. You okay?
It's my job as a new fault finder, but the uncertainty ends with us.
We didn't come millions of light years to die in a different place. I'm not letting the initiative down.
Pathfinder, the Tempest checks out. We're good.
There we go. Well, that was a crotch shot.
Take a
for
step.
Some reason.
You have no idea how long I've wanted a Pathfinder to see that.
Well, I'm glad we're here to do that, Suvi. So she's called Suvi, but she has what? An Irish accent?
Core is
or Scottish?
On.
I'm sorry.
Shields holding, adjusting entry.
You got this, right?
Yeah, aside from the radioactive sandstorms, we got this, right? Yeah.
Hell.
Oh, don't crash the ship on the first planet, please.
There.
Looks
set us down
quite
at this
empty.
Point.
There we go. Fancy looking trees. And our first planet, Eos. This is one hell of a ship, by the way. God damn, she looks cool. Okay, so apparently we're fixed on Liam and Cora for this one. Oh, and there goes the helmet. Search Site 1's main control building. This looks pretty cool.
Reports state this planet suffers deadly storms that are contaminated by radiation from the Scourge. Eos deployment was incomplete due to environmental hazards and ultimately hostile encounters.
Plus no Pathfinder. If Eos is like Habitat 7, that signal we scan must be connected with the atmosphere. We could use the outpost antenna to track it down. Let's get the power back on.
Okay, but
they must
I
have
am...
known these wouldn't last in these conditions.
They didn't have a Pathfinder.
They do now. We'll make Eos a home.
Okay, so that's great and all, but I'm gonna take a little break before we go on to exploring Eos. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again, enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.